wisdom. Chapter number 1, we even all my friends are watching. Very good. So chapter number 1 is also benefit of practicing Bodhisattva. So when we concentrate on the 10 benefit of Bodhisattva, we will be able to desire to achieve that in mind. When we achieve that in mind, we have to do purification. So then chapter number 2, then Shandita explained how to purify the mind. The 7 prayers and 4 attitudes and so on. And then in order to achieve the 2 times of Bodhisattva mind, we need to do preparation for kind of like inviting important guests. So therefore we are inviting all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. They are just like our witness, and taking a Bodhisattva vow in front of the all the Buddha and Bodhisattvas. So therefore chapter number 3, acquiring to achieve that mind. Once that mind is achieved, so we should not deteriorate, and we should not degenerate that mind. Therefore, in order to keep this mind, so practice carefulness. This is chapter number 4. So carefulness. And because Shantideva said mainly two great enemies will destroy our Bodhisattva mind. One enemy is self-centered attitude mind, and the grasping mind. This one will degenerate our Bodhisattva mind. Therefore, to increase and to practice the carefulness, which is the chakra. And then, chapter number 5 is then kind of like guarding introspection of awareness. So with the mindfulness, we are trying to strengthen this mind. Basically, we need foundation to build that mind. Many of you said like more ethic person, fundamental, on the basis of good morality and fundamental practicing guarding introspection. Many of you said moral person. Once you remember the moral person, you are very good. Fundamental base to practice to strengthen this mind. And then the next chapter is because of practicing patience, so patience, and anger, hatred, which is called the patience chapter. And then joyful effort. Concentration, and then chapter number 9, wisdom, and chapter number 10, dedication. So this comes from this chapter. Understand. Now here chapter number 4, I want to read this through. So last time it was so, which is conscientious. So there are two points, right? So number 1 is relationship of this, actual explanation of this text, and the name of the text, two points. actual explanation of the text, there are 3 points. How are you going to think about how to meditate with consciousness? Briefly, extensively, in summary, three points. Explanation of the text, 3 points. How to meditate on the consciousness briefly, extensively, and summary, 3. Now, how to meditate on consciousness briefly, for this so then this comes. Having firmly seized the awakening mind in this way, unquote, children must never remember, always should they ensue themselves and never stray from their practice. So that briefly, how to maintain concentration. So that means when this true mind generated, then we should keep this mind by practicing 6 perfections and 4 ways of helping others. So that's the point. Okay, now number 2. Automated extensively. Two points. Chantas can be applied. So first, conscientious about Buddhist mind, and secondly, conscientious about Buddhist awareness. The conscientious about Buddhist mind. 2 points. Chantas and don't remember. Chantas and don't remember means reason we should not give a bodhicitta mind. If you give a bodhicitta mind, many disadvantages. The reason why we should not give bodhicitta mind, so here in the case of reckless actions or of deed not well instructed, although a promise may have been made, it is fit to reconsider whether I should do them or not. So that is the bodhicitta mind is combined with wisdom. So it's not like you develop this mind because of the wisdom. Mind because of benefiting, and because you see the advantages and you see the purpose, you realize this when you practice this mind, give you joy, not only temporary but ultimate joy, happiness, not only you but all environment, you will give peace. So therefore, because of all these reasons, because you use your wisdom, not like mind. So therefore, because seeing an advantage and seeing the possible practicing of which the mind, you will not give up this mind. So constantly you carry, continuously you are to practice this. No matter what happens, I will not give up this mind. So not giving up. Okay, hang on, this. Remember, second is, first is not giving up bodhicitta mind. Second is disadvantage of giving that mind. So disadvantage of giving that mind have 3 points. Reborn in Gloria, the fold of degenerate, benefiting other sentiments, the fold of making long distance to achieve the path, mind. So, number one is fold of to be reborn in Gloria. Number two is you will degenerate, benefiting other certain things. Number three is your mind will become long distance to each mind. Okay. Now I'm going to do using so the fold of to be reborn in Gloria. 3 points. Reason to be reborn there. The Geshe La Ngawang Gedun, there is a sutra that I explained, and no contradiction about this three. Now, the reason why we will be reborn in Gloria, so that is here. How can I withdraw this mind? Because I promised in front of this the Bodhisattva, Bodhisattva with the witness. And then if I give this mind, then I will deceive the Bodhisattva. So therefore, then you will be reborn in the lower realm, because you promised in front of the Bodhisattva. You are witness, and now you are deceiving, so that goes for this. And then second is that if the sutra said that whenever Shariputra give up his bodhicitta, because some evil people come and ask him, give your hand. So Shariputra gave his right hand. Then later he said, I don't want your hand. So then immediately he went to Shariputra, came up his Buddhist mind. So as soon as he came up Buddhist mind, then he fall into the Hinayana path. So this explained in the sutra. So this Buddha said it is very comprehensive us to understand this reason, because it is beyond our ordinary mind, so only Buddha and higher being can understand. So that's the Shariputra. He gave up his right hand, and the person said, I don't want love. And then he was very depressed and gave up with each other. And then Dr. Hina and Apathy became Arhat. So this Buddha said, it is not object of our ordinary mind. It is beyond our ordinary mind. It is only higher beings and Bodhisattva will understand the reason. So the third is, first is an introduction, reason to be reborn in the lower realm, right? Shinji Lungkoba, that's the no contradiction. Contradiction means about this Shariputra, giving of his hand, no contradiction. You don't know why he gave this Buddhichita hand. Because we will not understand, we will not believe. So, higher being, they can understand. Then, Shinji Lungkoba means in the sutra, right? So, Buddha sutra said, and the Buddha said, even you are not giving small things with the motherliness, you will be reborn in hungry ghost. In the sutra, it has been taught by Buddha. Those who do not give away the smallest thing which they one intend to give will take rebirth at early birth. Just small things would be stingy, there's no question about other things like that. So that okay, then now here this goes with this one. Okay. Then, if I should deceive all beings, there's no questions. After having sincerely invited them to the unsuccessful bliss, shall I take happily rebirth? There's no question. Right? Even Buddha said in the sutra, just not giving small things will be rebirth. Then there's no question about deceiving all the beings, because sincerely invite all this to the Bodhisattvas and we promise Bodhisattvas. There's no question to be only the only thing can discern the manner of action of those who give up awakening mind, but are free to be beyond the scope of ordinary thought. That's Shariputra. Shariputra. When he give up his hand and give up his bodhicitta, he is beyond the ordinary thought. We don't know what we only higher being can know exactly why he did this. Tonight, good reading this. then here, now third is the second. Remember, we have this point. If you give a bodhicitta mind, you will fall to not helping other sentient beings. There are three points. Chandra said, if you degenerate bodhicitta mind, it's the heaviest defeat. Chandra said, you degenerate bodhicitta, it is great obstacle to handle other sentient beings. Therefore, you will be reborn, Lord. And the religion means. So, Even Bodhisattva is having difficulty. Yeah. You should. These four Bodhisattva is the heaviest of downfalls. You should ever happen. The world, fear, the world will be weakened. So, if you give a Bodhisattva mind, then you will lose. You will lose all sense of meaning. Because you give up all sense of meaning. So you should even single moment hinder or obstruct your personal needs by looking at the world from all, then you will not handle the rebirth of the world. So if you give up this Bodhisattva mind, then you have to continuously reborn in the samsara. There's no end of that. You keep going. So if may being is implied by destroying the joy of even one creature, then what there is need no mention. Is called the joy of creature last spirit. So that means the reason, if you just destroy one person's joy, consider to be negative. And there's no question to destroy the joy from the world of sentience. How much negative joy creative. It's like space. So because there is space, no boundary to the space. So one reason is that. So that means Bodhisattva, you know, Bodhisattva. You will create the merit if we respect Bodhisattva and pay homage and to thank Bodhisattva object of our object of our meditation. Because Bodhisattva, if you benefit Bodhisattva, then we will create huge amount of merit. Because there's no boundary of the merit. Because Bodhisattva activity is take responsibility to help all sentient beings. So therefore your merit is like space. No boundary of the speed. At the same time, if you disrespect Bodhisattva, also create negative, similar, like endless negative. Because Bodhisattva take responsibility to liberate all sentient beings. And if you benefit Bodhisattva, then good. Help Bodhisattva, then you will get huge amount of merit. Because of lack of merit, we cannot achieve realization. For example, Ramachandra, when we study learning, we cannot grasp all things. When we think and analyze, we are unable to grasp everything. When we concentrate on a particular object in meditation, we are unable to experience those in depth. So therefore, if we create the merit means put this up the object of the meditation. So when you create merit, formless merit, like space. Now third is fold of your mind long distance to achieve the path. So that is subtle thousands. So if you defeat, this is just like if you are healthy, your feet and hand is healthy, and when you work on your healthy feet and re-heal again, is totally different. Right? Before you are healthy, then you have accident and broken your leg. Later you re-heal, then your leg is completely different from what you have in the past. So similarly, that when you create a negative karma, you purify with this four antidote. But you purify, but you still if you distance your mind apart. You purify the negative energy, means you purify, you not reborn whatever you did. But you cannot, the distance to the mind apart is not more distant, just like, you understand what I'm saying? Do you understand? Means you purify your negative mind, but that cannot replace distance of your path. Your path distance longer and longer. You understand? Just like broken the heat, broken that your feet and reheat is different. So similar that this kind of thus those who have the force of awakening mind and well as the force of falling from it stay revolving within circle of existence, and for a long time now, hundred of the reaching the Bodhisattva level, so the distant. So if you are going to Egypt, Bodhisattva path of accumulation, if you are going close to path of accumulation, you will distant. That levels of the path. Before, for example, if you are going to achieve path of accumulation for 50 years, now distant 100 years, so this will be giving up this. But you purify, but distant, not replaced. Maybe some questions.
So, I guess what I'm understanding is like any transgression.
By purifying, ripening with the karma. Not purify the seed. Seed is much deeper. So if you ripening reserve of karma is purified, practicing for antidote, but seed will not purify. So that seed will make more distant. possibly kill until the Bodhisattva part of seeing. Luckily, you can kill part possibly, therefore, to the part.
Bodhisattva vows, when you do like some of the transgressions you can do all the time, like just hear the words.
It's
like extremely
in front of the statue of the repeating the Bodhisattva vows in front of the statue. Reminding yourself of divine medicine.
Okay.